Good morning, everyone. My name is Katie Threlkeld. I am an SLP and the Educational Program Developer for Forbes AAC. I am a paid employee of Forbes AAC. Today, we're going to talk about MindExpress, WinSlate's newest software. The audio and video should be turned off for y'all, but if you have any questions, feel free to put them in the chat throughout the webinar, or you can save them for the end. To start off, I want to talk about the WinSlate device that's offered through Forbes AAC. There's a lot of great features with the WinSlate. It comes with the adaptive multifunctional hub, a tough rugged case in Corning Gorilla Glass to make it really durable. It comes with Windows integration, and it also incorporates both symbol and text-based grids to fit the AAC user's unique communication needs. The WinSlate device can be accessed through head mouse, switch scanning, direct selection, and state-of-the-art eye tracking system. There's integrated front and rear cameras, and it can be mounted to wheelchairs, floor mounts, and tables. Another great feature about the WinSlate, it's incredibly lightweight. It's only 3.4 pounds, and that makes it really easy to transport from one environment to the other. Another thing I want to point out, a great feature with our WinSlate is that you can get the extender battery pack. This can last up to 16 hours, so the AAC user can always access their communication device, whether they're traveling, on a school field trip, if they're doing something outdoors. This extender battery allows them to not lose their ability to communicate when you're out and about and away from an outlet. As I said, you can experience up to 16 hours the normal use. It has incredible continuous runtime. And a great thing, our design engineering team at Forbes AAC created this to allow this external battery pack to be mounted directly to a wheelchair mounting tube. It can be mounted out of the way, so it's not in the way of the device or the user. And another great feature, it has a convenient cord management retainer to take up any of that cords so they're out of the way and not getting caught or hung up. And finally, I want to talk quickly just through the support that comes with the WinSlate. We have several video training tutorials. You can check out our YouTube page. Also within the WinSlate, we have our built-in remote help desk. The Forbes AAC, we provide lifetime technical support, and we also offer in-services and trainings to clinicians. So let's just go ahead and jump into Spark. Spark is powered by MindExpress. For the WinSlate, this represents Forbes, our proprietary package of communication systems, assessment supports, educational resources, and access tools. It also has grid sets for the language development kit with our interactive toys. It's truly designed to empower WinSlate users across the lifespan to connect, communicate, and grow. We'll watch a quick video on Spark.
Welcome to Spark. So this is our latest software that you will find on all of our WinSlate devices. It is designed in an organized way to provide quick navigation for addressing accessible needs of the user. So Spark is essentially a portal that has these different labeled folders that include corresponding page sets to address the communication and accessibility needs for a wide variety of users across all ages and diagnoses. The ultimate goal of Spark would be to identify the favored and appropriate page sets to customize then an individualized Spark profile for the user to meet their needs. So I want to quickly overview the different folders.
So as you can tell, this is our Spark portal. Now we'll go into step-by-step what all of these different page sets offer. Before you get into a page set, you've got to create a profile. So if you're at a clinic where you have several different patients or clients that are trialing the WinSlate device, know that you can add different profiles for different users. Super easy, you're going to go to the menu and click Change Profile, and then you're going to click Add Profile. Within that, you can name each user, and you can personalize it by choosing a language and a voice for the user. For the profile picture, you can choose an image from a file, or you can take a picture with the camera on the device. Another great thing is that you can also select an avatar. There's several of those pre-programmed on the software. When you're creating a profile for the first time, we want to make sure we're selecting the Mind Express starting pages from that portal that are appropriate for the user. There are several to choose from, including symbol communication, text communication. There's games and music, as well as educational options and different accessible apps. Know that if you do have several users, it's super easy to switch profiles. If multiple user profiles have been created, you can switch back and forth. You just go to the menu and click Change User. All the user profiles will appear, and then you can select the profile that you want. So as I said before, when you're creating a profile for the first time, you can select many different Mind Express starting page sets for the portal to customize it for the user. There are several different ones you can choose from, and we'll go through those now. Within Spark, we have several text-based communication page sets designed to turn text to speech quickly and naturally for the WinSlate users who are literate and can read and write. These page sets empower the individual to generate their messages with ease as they navigate between the keyboard, word prediction, and saved phrases. You can also access text, phone conversations, email, and social media platforms. First, we have Amigo. This is a text-based communication system. It includes a keyboard, custom phrases, contacts, phone calls, email, calendar, different games, desktop control, music, video, and more. On top of that, you can personalize by choosing a different color scheme, modifying the start page, and change the access method directly, as well as the keyboard layout. We also have a word prediction keyboard and word and phrase prediction keyboard. This is for users who aim to create novel messages with additional support of predictive phrases and words through that phrase and word prediction keyboard. Within this grid set, there is also an app for text messaging, phone calls, and email. The text message app allows a user to send a text message. If there's individuals you've added within the contact list, those individuals are going to show up automatically. With mobile phone, you can answer and make phone calls. And then with the email app, again, you can add contacts to your contact list. They'll come up automatically. You can type a message and then send and receive emails. There's several different accessible apps for connecting with others, and that's all available through the Spark portal. This includes Facebook, Skype, YouTube, Kindle, iTunes, Spotify, camera, and calendar. There's page sets provide, which really great, they provide large targets that are conducive to alternate access to navigate through favorite applications with ease. Next, another great feature of Spark, we have this grid set that has the option for users to really maintain and learn to control their environment, be really independent in their surroundings, and this is all through this grid set. Users can perform tasks such as changing the channel on a TV, turning the lights on and off, opening the garage door if their spouse or loved one is coming home, as well as locking and unlocking the door. This grid set is great for individuals with acquired disabilities to help them really gain and control their environment and have independence in their home. Next, I want to talk about the Core Word Language System. This provides AAC users with a powerful combination of core language, fringe vocabulary, as well as banks of key phrases. There's three levels, Core 6, 20, and 40. and this corresponds with the vocabulary layouts and content derived from studies of individuals with AAC across the lifespan. Levels increase from words most frequently used, or core words, for emergent communicators, and then it progresses to more complex content and grammar tools. This core word language system features dynamic vocabulary layouts that automatically change as the user makes selections. So once a word has been selected, the layout updates to show words that are likely to be used next. By offering these next words in plain view and removing unwanted vocabulary, users don't have to waste time and energy searching for their next words. This predictive nature ensures maximum efficiency with a minimal learning curve. So a little bit more about core word. First, we have core word 6. This is great for emergent communicators or users who are new to AAC. This has a 3x2 grid set and it has larger buttons. So that's great for someone who needs to learn to access their device and needs the support of larger buttons. Core word 6 supports Brown Stage 1. It has a really intuitive and efficient interface. It provides core vocabulary as well as key fringe vocabulary such as mom or ball. It provides evidence-based language content as well as interactive learning grids and cause and effect teaching tools. With core word 20, this is where we see the AAC users beginning to build phrases and sentences. This is a 5x4 grid set that includes everything provided in core word 6 with additional features. This will now support Brown stages 1 through 4. It has predictive linking that keeps the words you need right at the fingertips. There's also comments and descriptive concepts, as well as emergency and medical phrases for that AAC user who is learning to communicate about their safety, health, and well-being. There's visual schedule templates for AAC users who might need that in their school schedule or their day-to-day schedule, as well as ABC and QWERTY keyboards. Finally, we have core word 40. This introduces more complex language functions. There's an 8x5 grid set that includes everything provided in core word 20 with some additional features. This is now going to support Brown stages 1 through 5. It has advanced predictive features that increases efficiency. There's a wide variety of grammatical markers. And there's a robust chat folder that allows expression of common phrases at the touch of a single button that really maximizes social communication. Next, we have symbol links. This is available in 4, 8, 12, 20, and 30 button grid sets. This is a great symbol-based communication system. It provides support for those who are not yet literate. It's really designed to enable users to find words quickly and easily. With Symbol Links 4, this is great for emergent communicators. It features 4 cells per page, providing rapid message selection for basic communication needs, such as a person's name or personal information, as well as quick phrases and requests for help. With Symbol Links 8, this is going to feature 8 cells per page. It supports language functions, including making requests, providing personal information, greeting others, and asking questions. Moving to Symbol Links 12, this builds upon previous levels of the Symbol Links series. It is going to incorporate an even wider variety of vocabulary categories and context-specific messages. Symbol Links 20, this 20-cell layout is going to provide ongoing support for those who are learning to combine different words into phrases. It also provides categorically organized vocabulary. This is going to provide a quick-fire phrase, quick-fire phrases right on the main page, and it includes a keyboard for spelling and literacy support. And finally, we have Symbol Links 30. This is the most comprehensive grid set in the Symbol Links series. Topics include community outings, hobbies. It has categorically organized vocabulary. that's going to support a wide range of expressing different wants and needs. Again, this is going to provide those essential quick-fire phrases that will help maximize the speed of communication in social communication. Next, I want to talk about steps to language. This is a vocabulary package that was designed to support children to develop the skills needed for symbol-based communication. This was specifically designed for children using AAC right from the beginning of their journey, moving towards developing more complex language skills. This was developed by Sarah Alderman. She's a SLP who's worked with individuals using AAC for over 10 years. The steps to language, it has three stages. Enables the user to gradually build their language skills in a similar way that young children learn to speak verbally. Some different features within the system includes a simple color-coded navigation system, access to an increasingly larger selection of core words, a really great guided selection system. So when a core word is selected, a pathway is highlighted to suggest folders that the child might be looking for to continue building a phrase. It has access to quick phrases for social language, as well as a phonic-based keyboard with predictive text that's going to support developing literacy skills. Next, I want to talk about the Spark grid set that we provide that is compatible with our language development kit. So these are ready-to-use grid sets that were professionally developed that are specific to each activity. These grid sets are fully programmed with infrared commands and activity-specific vocabulary that can be used with our clinical protocols. These remote-controlled toys are great. They offer many benefits, including teaching a child to learn to independently control their environment and explore their environment. It offers a really motivating experience, as well as natural language opportunities. There's several different interactive sensory toys, including the wizard wall car, a unicorn. We have a couple robots, triceratops that roars. We have a car track and a puppy. These again go with our language development kit, which includes our clinical protocols that were developed by SLPs who specialize in AAC. These protocols include lesson plans, goal banks, as well as data tracking sheets. Next, I want to talk about these eyegaze tools that come with Spark. First, we have Maximize. This is a set of Mind Express activities that engage and motivate the users as they discover eyegaze and eye interaction. It's really going to teach users how to focus on a single target and then move them to choosing between multiple targets and building up skills in selecting moving objects. It's really fun. It can be really interactive for AAC users that are just learning eyegaze, especially kids. They can tickle a penguin to make them laugh. They can grow flowers with their eyes, and they can look and see what's hiding beneath a pile of leaves. From a clinician standpoint, a heat map can be created that's going to show the areas that they were focused on. Next, we have the eyegaze accuracy test. This was designed specifically to evaluate a user's ability to activate bullseye targets of various sizes on the screen. You can choose from different grids, anywhere from 6 up to 60 cells. There's also several games that are great for users who are learning eyegaze. We have a fart monster game that's super fun for kids. We also have a game where they can knock down cans. Spark users can use the interactive learning collection of different large target games that are optimized for eyegaze control and learning. We also offer WinSlate videos for kids with quick access to videos such as Elma and the beloved Peppa Pig. Finally, we have our grid set of entertainment and games. This is great for individuals across the lifespan. This offers a large selection of familiar games for individuals of all ages and interests. These page sets were designed for optimal access method assessment and training in a really motivating and engaging way. It includes Battleships, Connect Four, Word Games, Tic-Tac-Toe, and Minesweeper. There are several things that this new software we're using with our WinSlate offers in addition to what was provided before. We now have gaming for all ages. As I said, that can be a really motivating way to assess eyegaze in older individuals. Another great thing is there's the ability to undo changes after saving. It can be really beneficial if you're doing some editing or customization. We now offer access to Office 365, as well as the ability to schedule calendar appointments with alarm notifications all through the WinSlate. You can also do a global symbol set conversion, as well as global find and replace for symbols to really personalize it for the user. So instead of going one by one, button by button, you can do global replacement. You can access this comparison sheet at our website, forbesaac.com. Under the product tab, select Spark, and then scroll to the bottom and select the software comparison sheet. Finally, I want to point out the Mind Express manual. This is available at that website. It provides really great step-by-step operating instructions, including how to get started, the different functions within Mind Express, as well as profile and system settings, and working with cells, pages, and page sets. We are often asked by individuals on how to save and transfer a profile, and this manual can walk you right through it. As always, please connect with us. We have an Instagram page, Facebook, and Twitter, as well as a YouTube page with several help videos. As always, please contact me with questions or comments. This recorded webinar will be available through our website, forbesaac.com, in about a week time. Additionally, stay tuned for additional help videos for Spark on a future webinar, as well as on our YouTube site and our website. If you have any questions at this time, go ahead and put them in the chat. So I have one user who wanted to know if Pod is available on Spark. Yes, Pod is available on Spark. That is an option. So if you have a user who needs Pod, that is available on Spark and can be put on our WinSlate. If there's no more questions at this time, thank you so much for attending and have a great day. Bye.